Remember, slow down. Do you drive very fast? See what happens when you drive very fast?
所以放慢，如果你驾驶驾太快的话，你看到什么后果吗？
Right. Life also is the same, you know. You gotta learn to slow down. Okay? Like what the Bible says in Exodus chapter 14, verse 13 to 14.
然后生活也是一样，我们要学习放慢脚步，就好像出埃及记第14章第13到第14节。Yeah,
you want to read?
摩西对人民说：“不要惧怕，要站着，观看耶和华今天为你们施行的拯救，因为你们今天看见的埃及人，必永远不再看见了。耶和华必为你们征战，你们必须安静，不要作声。”
Okay, so learn to slow down, learn to be still. One way to do it is learn to breathe, right? Your breathing can help you to slow down.
然后要稳住，然后要放慢，放松自己的心情，然后能够帮助到你的上来，就是要学习放缓的那个呼吸。
Alright, so today we're going to talk about the power of language.
然后今天我们将会谈到就是语言的力量。
You know, language is very important, right?
语言是非常重要，对不对？
Do you believe language is very important?
相信吗？
More important than mathematics.
比数学还要重要。
No. It's true. You have no language, you cannot... What is it? Communicate mathematics.
是真的，如果你没有语言的话，你就没有办法沟通数学。
Right? If you have no language, how is your, if you go to school, how is your teacher, if she has no language, how is she going to communicate mathematics to you?
如果没有语言的话，你想象一下你的学校老师怎么样去教你数学呢？
You know, if you have no language, how are you going to read books that communicate the education?
如果没有语言的话，你怎么样就是读关于教育的书呢？
And you know language, how you gonna speak to one another and understand each other deeply?
然后当你掌握了语言的话，你就可以直接和双方沟通，这样了解彼此。
So, language is very important.
语言是非常重要的。
Alright, so. From a biblical point of view, in Proverbs chapter 18, verse 21, it says here what? Death and life are in the power of what? The tongue. The language is like a sword. You know?
所以圣经里面有提到，在箴言第18章21节，生与死都在石头的权下，爱把弄这柄这权柄的人必失其国，也就是说，语言是吧，就好像跟双刃剑这样。
Your language can either build somebody up, make them really happy with you, or it can tear somebody down.
另外一句话呢，就是你的语言能够造就对方，让人家非常开心，又或者是把对方打倒。
Okay, if you remember last year, we talked about what? Guarding your heart, right? Your language. You know, don't go around saying, hey, why are you so stupid?
还记得去年吗？我们谈到就是讲去保守你的心，然后其中一项就是关于到语言的，就是说不要随随便便说啊，去外面跟人讲，哎，为什么你这么笨？Because
that language, right? That word, those words can hurt the other person and tear them down.
因为那一些字眼，那一些语言能够撕裂或者是伤别人的心，这样让人家绊倒。And
governments have done that, right? Propaganda during the war. World War II, the Japanese would come and send leaflets to the citizens. The Germans would fly through the area and send leaflets to the citizens. And when people read it, they get discouraged because of what? Bad news.
然后在第二次世界大战的时候是吗？那些侵犯人家国土的那些占领国是吗？也是做过同样的东西，他们就会飞过那个被占领的国家那个。 天空那一边，然后放下那一些纸条还是纸屑，告诉大家就是说，他们战败了这样。
Right, coming close to home, our language can either make us close to our family or push us away.
然后来到我们自己的原生家庭的话，我们的语言能够拉近彼此的距离，又或是把它推开。
Okay, you have your mom and dad, brothers and sisters. They are always very gentle, very kind, very encouraging. You feel like, yeah, I like this family. I want to be close to them.
你发现到有一些父母或者是哥哥姐姐是吗？是非常善良的，然后讲话非常有鼓励性的，然后你很想要接近这一个家庭这样。
But if you have a family, mom and dad, or brothers and sisters who is always belittling you, the way they speak makes you feel small. You feel like running away.
可是如果你是生长在一个家庭里面有父母还是兄弟姐妹是吗？不断的贬低你的话是吗？你会觉得你想要远离这个家庭。
So today we're going to talk a little bit more deeper about language.
然后今天我们将会稍微深入的探讨语言。
Again, and how our mind, all right, relate to language.
然后我们的思想怎么样去跟那个语言连贯
？So this is called relational frame theory.
这是相对框架的那个理论呢、啊。
Too deep, too cheap, right? What's the Chinese word? Relational frame theory. RFT. It's a very powerful theory that helps you to understand the power of language that can either help you or destroy you.
然后是一个很有能力的那个理论，这样它能够让你知道，就是说你的语言是吗？怎么样去帮助到你，或者是伤害你
？Right, just like what the Bible says, right? Language, it's either a death to you or gives you life.
像圣经说的。语言可能是 给你生命，又或是死亡的。
Again, our mind very powerful, right? God gave us our mind, wonderful mind, beautiful mind.
然后我们的思想是很有能力，对不对？然后神给我们一个很美丽的那一个思想。
So according to this theory, right? Our mind, your brain. Again, we have our brain, right? Have you seen your brain before?Better not.
你看过你的大脑吗
？Right, but you seen movies that show the brain. You know that mushy mushy gray color thing, very soft, but has all the information. That brain, okay, that is in your skull.
然后 OK 你在电影里面看到就是我们的脑就好像一片豆腐这样，对不对？然后这个豆腐上嘛是储藏了很多很多那些资料跟记忆的。
It's an incredible, it is an incredible muscle, you know.
然后是一个很让人家惊讶的细胞来的。
That God has given us.
然后这是神赐给我们的一个器官。
Right, our brain makes us different from the animals.
然后就是我们的这一颗脑是吗？把我们从野生动物或者是动物那边区分出来。
So one of the ability of the brain is this. Again, the brain has many ability, but some of the ability of the brain is that the mind, all right, the role of the mind is to what? First observe and collect information.
然后我们的大脑是吗？是有很多功能、很多能力的。然后其中一个能力的话，就是我们能够观察，然后吸收那一个资讯。
Okay, just like me, I look here, I collect information. There's Carmen, there's Hui Sim, there's Helen, there's Wai, there's Patrice. I collect information. There's somebody, Ying Ying and Fred.Right, I collect information, but whether I remember the information or not, that's a different story.
Okay, 就好像我站在台上的样子嘛，我其实看着你们的时候，是吧？我也是在收集这些资料，至于那个资料有没有用，是吗？就另当别论了。
Again, and after we collect those information, we store it in our brain, just like a computer, you store it in your brain.
啊，当我们收集了这些资料的话，是吧？我们就把它储存在我们的脑里面，就好像电脑这样。
And the other thing that is so wonderful about our mind is this. It takes all those information and it connects them together.
然后我们思想还是我们大脑神奇的地方呢，就是它能够接受所有的那些资料，是吗？然后 让这些资料什么形成的一些关系网这样。
Okay, and it connects them together in a way so that you can relate one information to another information so that what? You can solve your problems easier and faster.
然后它能够就是把一些资讯还是事情什么联系起来，以便能够帮助你去解决你生活上的一些问题，而且更加快、更加有效解决。
Okay, so this information connects itself just like the World Wide Web. You know, all everything you type a word, right? Bicycle, and all of a sudden, millions of information come out.
啊，就好像我们互联网这样，你在谷歌上面是吗？这边搜寻，就是说脚踏车的话是吗？你一 key 进去的时候啊，它就出来。百万样的结果了。
Okay, but the beauty of a mind that is even greater than the internet is this: the word bicycle can relate to all the other information that is associated to bicycle.
然后我们大脑，我们思想最棒的地方呢，就是这一个电单车，脚踏车这一个姿势嘛，可以和我们身边的其他事情联系在一起。
So.Our mind uses language. Okay, the reason why it connects information like a web, like a frame, because what it uses language to help us solve problems faster.
所以我们大脑是吗？用我们的思想去收集资料，然后把这些资料是吗联系起来，以便我们能够更有效、更快的去解决一些问题。
All right, but language, yeah.Also create problems.
那同时，语言也会制造出问题。
Again, you sound confused already. You seem confused. What do you mean language create problem? Don't language beautiful one?
有些人可能开始混淆了啊， right. 什么意思呢？
Language create problems. Language creates suffering for you. You feel anxious because of language.
然后有时语言也会造成你不安。
You feel fearful because of language.
又或者是你会产生畏惧这样。
You feel discouraged because of language.
你会失望因为语言的关系。
Okay, really, is it that mean? Yes.
这是真的。
Okay, I'm going to show you a short little video, and then after that, I'll explain a little bit more.
Okay, 我们来看看一个视频，然后等一下我们解释。
All right, now the English in this video is a little bit fast.So, try to catch the big picture.
然后这个视频里面的英文是吗？有点快，所以不过没有关系尝试就是去捕抓这一个视频的纲要。
Okay, if you don't quite understand, it's okay. I'll explain to you.
如果你不明白，没有关系等一下我会解释。
All right. Okay.
When we are born and brand new.We are like a clean, blank slate. As humans, we have a unique ability to understand language and cognition. From a very young age, we start to create derived relations and create triangles of thought. Here is an example. This is a Zinke Fonk. This is a Zinke Fonk. A Zinke Fonk goes, wee! A Zinke Fonk goes, wee! What goes, wee?And what is this? So when we see and hear, we spontaneously create...
Oh, sorry.
When we are born and brand new, we are like a clean, blank slate. As humans, we have a unique ability to understand language and cognition.From a very young age, we start to create derived relations and create triangles of thought. Here is an example. This is a Zinke Fonk. This is a Zinke Fonk. A Zinke Fonk goes, wee! A Zinke Fonk goes, wee! What goes, wee? And what is this? So when we see and hear, we spontaneously create an extra derived relation.So when you see a Zinke Fonk, you will probably hear, wee! And when you hear, wee! You will probably think of a Zinke Fonk. We also learn other relationships, before and after, cause and effect, bigger and smaller, less and more. As these triangles of thought evolve, we stop seeing ourselves as separate from them, and we start to see the world through them. These networks only ever expand. There is no undo button, and they continue to grow at a vast rate until we can no longer see ourselves and our thoughts as separate. We think we are these thoughts and beliefs. And where do the majority of these thoughts and beliefs come from? From our parents, teachers, family, friends, enemies, society, the media, anything we watch, read, or hear can be added to our network of thoughts and beliefs. So these thoughts may not always be helpful. In fact, a lot of these connections we make can be harmful or damaging to us. These kinds of thoughts can lead to emotions like shame. And because we often find painful emotions like shame too hard to bear, we try to avoid this pain by blotting them out with alcohol, drugs, overworking, or avoidance of life in general. But these never solve the problem. They just make it worse, because then we have the original painful emotion, plus an addiction, plus painful thoughts and feelings and emotions about our addiction. So we have just added pain to our pain. Can you see the cycle? Our networks just get bigger and bigger and create a sticky web we can get stuck in. We all experienced early pain in varying degrees, and we all developed different ways of responding to it. That initial pain could have been not getting our basic needs met, basic needs like love, kindness, acceptance, empathy, or autonomy. We all developed patterns of thoughts, beliefs, and behaviours to deal with this early pain. These set of patterns or beliefs, thoughts, and behaviours are not usually unique to us and can be loosely illustrated by these groups. A sense of superiority and grandiosity, vulnerability and abandonment, or acting out and being antisocial. But the most common pattern is that we feel trapped by these thoughts and beliefs. We believe that we are broken, unlovable, weak, or bad. And when we believe these thoughts as the truth, they can create a breeding ground for anxiety and depression. Because of the sticky nature of these webs, we can be blinded by our beliefs. We can also get stuck in other people's webs if their web feels familiar to us, even if they might not be healthy for us. So we can end up trying to care for or rescue others that treat us poorly, but ultimately, as adults, we can only be responsible for ourselves and our own happiness. So it is vital we can step outside of our own webs to see that we are not our web of thoughts and beliefs, and to recognise other people's too, so we don't get stuck there either. An easy way to imagine it is to imagine we all have our own wheelie bin where we keep our own sticky webs of thoughts and beliefs and behaviours. But instead of seeing ourselves as separate from our bins, we all climb in, and most of us live our lives from inside the bin. We also label our bins. Can you see how this causes us problems? So how do we step outside our bins? Well, hopefully this video has helped give you some insights into how we create and get stuck in our own webs and bins. To step outside our webs and bins, we need to become the observer and see we are separate from our thoughts and beliefs. This is why mindfulness and meditation are so helpful. They allow us to become the curious observer of all our thoughts and beliefs. We start to see the web of stories we tell ourselves about ourselves. We can also learn ACT skills to unhook from difficult thoughts. Here are some useful ones. When you notice you are having an unhelpful thought, for example, I am a loser, try replacing it with, I notice I am having the thought that I'm a loser. This separates you from your thought. Or try saying it in a funny voice, or see it being iced on a cake, or flying by on a banner behind a plane. We are not ridiculing our minds. We should love our minds. They are only ever trying to help us. Our minds are amazing at problem solving, planning, predicting, evaluating, and creating. It's just that they are not great at solving emotional problems, which is why we need to be able to step outside the webs we have created to spot unhelpful or erroneous connections. We all have these sticky webs. We all have these labels we have created for ourselves. Most of these painful connections were created at an early age when we were too young to understand they were not helpful or true. So it is not our fault, and it is not our mind's fault. It was just doing what minds do, which is collecting and connecting information and trying to make sense of it all. But as adults, we are responsible for our choices and actions and behaviours and have to accept the consequences of these choices, actions and behaviours. So when we are free from the web of thoughts and behaviours, we can see clearly. We gain psychological flexibility and can make better choices for ourselves and others. Our bin contains our history. They are part of us, and we can never get rid of them, and we wouldn't want to. They are full of great and helpful stuff, as well as the unhelpful parts. And even when you do see we are separate from our webs and bins, we will all fall back into them from time to time, because that is human nature. So don't beat yourself up when you do. It's just the more often we can climb back out again, then the better our lives will become. So because they are our history, could you be kind to the younger part of you that thought these painful messages were true? When we step outside our web and bins, we gain clarity of mind. When you have clarity of mind, you make better choices, and better choices change what you do and help you become the person you want to be and lead the life you want to live. I hope this helps. Lots of love, your ACT auntie.
Okay, too cheap. All right, what is this? No, what is this? Zinky Fong. And what does it say? Okay, very important here. Do you notice that the author, the speaker, mentioned the name only a few times?
也没有注意到这个作家还是画这一个图案的人是吧？只是提到这一个东西的名字几次而已。
Okay, only a few times. But you already remember.
可是你已经记得了。
What sound does it make?
它发什么声音出来？
So what's the point? The point is, every word that is said is stuck in your mind.
所以重点就是他讲的每一个字是吗？其实都已经存入了你的脑海里面。
Okay, every word that you hear from your mom and dad, brothers, sisters, friends, it's stuck there.
从你父母、兄弟姐妹还是朋友听到的那些话是吗？都进入你的脑海了。
There's no such thing as I want to erase it. It can never be erased.
然后你没有可能去清除还是消除这一些记忆的。
Okay, what does it say? You're all quiet. What does it say? See, it's there. Right? It's stuck. That's why, you know, when people say, either forgive and forget, that is an absolutely 100% not true statement.
所以呢，当人家告诉我们，就是我们要原谅和忘记的话，是吗？那个是100%错误的。Because
you can forgive, that's true, but you will never forget.
确实的，你可以去原谅，可是你不可能忘记的。Because
the memory already is stored there. It's unlike computer, you can never erase your memory.
然后这个记忆是吧，已经存在你的脑里面了。 然后不像是电脑这样，你可以删除掉。然后脑海里面记忆是很难的。Okay,
I'm going to explain a little bit more. Okay, slowly, so that hopefully you can understand. So, this is you.
来，我解释多一点啊。打个比方，这个是你。Right.
So assume this is you. So you have a baby.
然后你有一个孩子，是一个婴孩。
Alright. So there's a direct connection. Okay, this is you, you have a baby. That's a direct relationship.
然后你和这个孩子是吗？是有直接的关系。
And your baby, you have a baby called Jewel.
然后你的孩子是吗？就叫做 Jewel.
So there's a direct connection. Again, you, baby, named Jewel.
然后这一个孩子的名字跟你是吗？又有另外一层关系.
Okay. What's his baby name? What's the baby name? How do you know? I didn't tell you. What if you have three babies?
你怎样知道你这个孩子啊是否明智呢？啊，万一你有三个孩子呢？
Okay. So this is what we call indirect or derived connection.
然后这些呢，就是我们所谓的间接或者是啊，我们脑建立起来的那一些关系。
And the power of that is what it helps you to solve problems quicker, like a detective.
然后这一个能力的好处是吗？是帮你更快的解决问题，就好像侦探这么样。
Right? You see movies, right? The detective. Oh, clue A, clue B, clue C. Ah! Then, because of clue A, clue B, clue C, he is the guilty one. Even though they didn't see what he did.
如果你看那些侦探片的话，是吗？那些侦探会找，就是说线索这样啊，打比说线索 A、线索 B、线索 C 这样哦，因为这三个线索啊，让我相信，让我做一个结论啊，这一个有罪的这样。
Okay, so your brain make assumptions, connect all those information, connects you, connects baby, connects jewel, and it derive a relationship between this baby and jewel.
所以我们的啊脑海是吗，就建立一些假设，然后我们啊就利用了就是你跟这个婴孩的关系，还有这个你跟那个名字的关系，然后建立了这一个啊间接的关系，就是说这个孩子的名字叫 Jewel。
Okay, is it amazing? Our brain, God gave us this brain that connects everything, you know.
啊，是不是很？帮呢，神给我们这个大脑能够连接一切的。
Alright, but at the same time, it's a problem. You said baby equal jewel.
然后同时是吧，也是一个问题，因为哇，这个这个间接的关系是吗，让我们有一个错觉，就是说这个孩子的名字一定是 jewel.
Because the baby might not be jewel.
啊，因为这个婴孩是吗？真正的名字不一定是 Jewel， Jewel 可能是他其中一个孩子的名字而已。
Alright, then your friend told you there's a lady that goes around town with a baby pram. Everywhere she goes, she has a baby pram.
然后啊，你的朋友是吗？告诉你，就是说有一个女人，然后在这个小镇里面是吗？啊，每一次出门都会推着一个那个手推车。
Alright, so that's a direct, you heard about it, that's a direct relationship.
然后当你听到这则新闻的时候是吗，还是消息的时候是吗，你就建立了一个直接的，跟你这样有一个直接的那一个关系。
Okay, and you heard that this lady's name is Candy.
然后你听说这一个女士的名字叫做 Candy.
Okay, so that's a direct information, right, between the lady with the pram and her name is Candy.
所以这一个女士，这一个推手推车的女士和这个名字 Candy 上有个直接关系。
And you heard that this lady with the pram that goes around town likes to steal babies.
那同时你也听说这一个女士啊也喜欢偷婴孩。
Okay, again, there's a direct information, direct connection between this lady and stealing baby.
然后，这个女士是吧？同时又建立了一个直接关系，就是说这个女士偷婚啊，喜欢偷婴孩。
So what does Candy like to do? Okay, see your mind just.
所以 Candy 喜欢做什么
？Indirectly derive the information. Again, is it true or not true? You never know. But to help you solve problems.It connects.
所以间接的啊，我们就建立了一个啊非直接的关系，就间接的关系叫 Candy 是会偷小孩的。
Okay, that's why as you grow older, wow, you know you can think faster. Little children cannot connect information as fast as you grow older.
所以你发现到说啊，成人啊能够处理还是能够啊思想更多的东西一样，因为相对来讲小孩子他们没有办法就是建立这一些啊关系网。所以他们理解的那个速度没那么快。
But the more you explain, the more you tell them information language, the faster they connect.
所以当你 跟一个孩子是吧，更多的解释，让灌输他更多那个资讯的话，帮助他们做这些连接的话是吧，啊，他们就越容易去处理这一些资讯。
Okay, then you saw a neighbor move into town next to you. Okay, empty house. The neighbor moved in.
然后你也看啊，过后呢，你看到你邻居是吧，搬来了一个新的家庭。
And the neighbor has a, so again, direct information, right? You saw the neighbor. And the neighbor has a wonderful, beautiful wife, has a wife with a pram.
然后 OK, 你和这个邻居是吗，有了一个直接关系，因为你看到这个邻居。然后同时这一个邻居有一个很美丽的那个太太，然后她通常也是，她也是有一个手推车。
Right? Again, direct information, direct relationship.
然后你又能够建立一个直接的关系了，就是说邻居有个太太。
So, the lady's friend name, his wife name is Candy.
然后这个邻居的太太的名字是吧，又是 Candy.
Okay, so he introduced, hey, my wife is Candy.
他给你介绍，就说啊，我老婆的名字叫做 Candy.
So what is this lady's name?How do you know? You derive the information.
所以这一个女士的名字叫什么？叫 Candy 啊，因为你能够制造这一个非间接啊，不，这个间接的关系。
Right? You heard, you saw the woman, and you heard my wife's name is Candy. So you think, oh, yeah, wife, right? Name Candy, must be. She must be Candy. But he could have three wives, you know.Hopefully not, right? Not disciple.
所以当你的邻居跟你讲我的太太叫做 Candy 的时候，然后你看到身边有一个女士的话说啊，你就间接的能够联想到就是哦，这个就是她太太，然后啊应该叫 Candy 这样。可是你怎么知道她没有三个太太呢？
Okay, then one day, your friend came to you. Hey, I heard you like fishing. Let's go fishing.Then you say, no one take care of my baby. They say, hey, no problem. My wife, Candy, will help you with the baby.
所以呢，有一天呢，你的邻居送来就来救你去钓鱼这样。然后你就讲，哎呀，没有办法啦，不可以啦，没有人照顾我的孩子呢。然后呢，邻居说，没问题，我的太太是吧，能够帮你照顾孩子啊。Candy 能够帮你照顾孩子。
Okay, so you and Jim can go out fishing, and Candy will come to your home.And stay with your baby to babysit.
所以你和你的邻居是吧，可以去钓鱼，然后啊，他的太太 Candy 是吧，就可以来你的家里是吧，帮你照顾孩子。
So what is Candy going to do?
So Candy 会做什么呢？
And what do you think you're going to be doing? Protect your baby.
你或许会。间接的制造一个联想，就是说这个 Candy 可能会透露我的婴孩，然后你会怎么做呢？你可能要保护你的孩子吧。
So do you notice the beauty of your mind? It solves problem, you know. It tries to protect you. Oh, this Candy, maybe it's this Candy. It tries to protect you because the information derive. This is not direct, you know. Derive information, your assumption. Steal baby. Hey, I better not go fishing with that guy. I better protect my baby.
所以这就是我们脑海我们的思想的那一个美丽的地方，它帮助我们保护我们这样。所以当你看到这一些间接的关系的时候是吗，你可能会怀疑这个 Candy 和那个偷小孩的 Candy 是同一个人，所以会保你会起了保护孩子的那一个意识。
So language beautiful. So how does it create problem for you? How does it create suffering for you?
所以语言是很棒，对不对？那它怎么样去造成你伤害还是痛苦呢
？Okay, so the problem is this: What if this Candy here is not this Candy? She's actually a super nice lady, very caring Christian. And if you get to know her, wow, she'll turn out to be your best friend and best support.
然后问题是出现在万一这你的邻居的太太这个 Candy 是吗，不是那一个偷小孩的 Candy 呢？ 你可能跟这个 Candy 相处过后，你会发现到说啊，她是最一个非常非常好的那个女生这样，然后啊，她可以成为你最好的朋友，然后最好的支持这样。
Okay, but the problem is because of the way our mind process language, our fear shows up.
所以问题呢就是啊，当我们的脑在边处理我们得到的这些资讯，通过语言得到资讯的时候，是吧？这也造成我们会有这些戒心。
And so we avoid, right? You just avoided your neighbor, who could have been your best friend, and who could help you so much. So you lost something, and that becomes a suffering.
然后就是我们起了这个疑心还是戒心的话，是吗？所以我们就开始远离我们的邻居，然后我们失去了呢，就是失去了一个结交一个很好能够帮助我们的一个朋友，然后这就是我们的痛苦。
So language help you solve problem, but it can also create a lot of suffering for you.
所以呢，语言能够帮我们解决问题，不过同时也会造成一些痛苦。
Okay, for example, the word bad, right? Bad. Okay, what do you think about when you say the word bad?
打个比喻这样，就是说，当你提到坏这个字，你会想到什么？
Bad food, right? Or useless, what do you think about? Useless equipment.
又或者是没用的仪器这样，你会想到什么？
What do you do with useless equipment?
没用的仪器你会做什么？
Throw away.
丢掉，对不对？
Okay. Physically, you throw things away.
然后我们把那一个东西固体的东西是吗丢掉
okay, but the problem when you look at yourself and you say I am useless
可是问题呢当我们看待我们自己没用的时候
right sometimes your mind tells you why you make the stupid mistake you are useless
あ、有时我们的脑海在边责怪我们，就是说为什么我做了一个这么笨的错误，这样真的是没用。
So what do you do with useless thing? You throw them away. So you feel like quitting. Better throw me away.
所以，当东西没用的时候，你怎么处理呢？你把它丢掉，对不对？所以当你觉得自己没用的时候，是吗？你也把自己放弃了。
I'm useless, so better get rid of me.Isn't that true? The next statement comes better. Hey, if I'm useless to you, carry on me. I quit lah.
所以，既然我这样没有用的话说啊，那你就淘汰我吧，放弃我吧，这样。
Right? Language solve problem, but it also creates a lot of suffering.
所以就是这样啊，语言能够帮我们解决问题，同时也制造痛苦。
That's why, you know, Bible are so awesome, right? Even before science came out, Bible already came out with this idea.
所以圣经是很棒，对不对？在科学还没有研究出这一个理论的时候圣经已经提到了。
Okay, Ephesians 4:29, the Bible says what? Watch, let no corrupting talk come out from your mouth, but only good for building other up as fits its occasion, and it may givegrace to those who hear.
以弗所书第四章第二十九节
Watch what you say.
要小心，就是说要谨慎的看待你所说的。
So the same thing, language. Okay? Proverbs 12:18. Rash words is like a sword.Rash words is like a sword.
箴言第十二章第十八节，说话浮躁的人如刀刺人。
Okay, when someone say, "I hate you,"
所以当人家说我讨厌你，我恨你，就好像一把刀刺进你的身上。
It's just words, but it hurts, you know.
然后只是语言而已，可是它却能够伤害我们。
Well, couples, when you say to each other, "Wow," when you quarrel, "Wow, my ex-girlfriend better than you.
又或者是夫妻吵架的时候，他们说出的那种狠话，就是说我的前女友比你还好呢。
It's just words, but it watch its steps.
然后，虽然只是语言，可是它却能够刺痛我们。
You know, but the Bible says what? The language or the tongue of the wise bring healing.
可是同时，圣经也说到，就是
language brings
智慧人的舌头却为义人的良药。
You know, when you say, "Hey, I forgive you, I love you," is that nice? Honey, I love you. Husband, do you still say that to your wife?
所以当我们说到就是说我原谅你，我爱你，这样不是很好吗？
It brings healing. Hey, but that's not me, leh. I'm Chinese. Chinese don't say I love you.
然后它能够带来我们的治愈，对不对？然后你可能说啊，这不是我啦。然后我们华人是吗？不会讲华语的。Again,
so what's the point? It's not about being Chinese or being American. It's about being a Christian.
然后重点是呢，不是在乎你是华人还是美国人，而是你是一个基督徒。
So we have to learn to be a disciple, a Christian.
所以我们要学习成为一个基督徒。
Even the way we speak, right? Soft answer turns away anger. But when there's harsh word, whoa, dynamite.
然后箴言15:1回答温柔使怒消退，语言暴力触动怒气。
So when you argue, right? Watch your tone. You know, you can have conflict, okay? Doesn't mean you cannot have conflict, doesn't mean you cannot feel angry, but the way you say, is it up there like a volcano, or is it calm and gentle?
所以当你起争执的时候，要小心你的那一个口气，这样。 不是说你不能够生气，你不能够起争执这样。可是当你发脾气，当你起争执的时候，你的口音是不是好像火山爆炸这样，爆炸这样，还是很平静的。
I love this one. This one very important for all of us. Hebrews 4:12 says what? For the word of God is living and active, sharper than any double-edged sword. Piercing to dividing soul and spirit, joints and marrow, and discerning thoughts and intention of the heart.
所以我很喜欢这一节经文，希伯来书第4:12。神的道是活泼的，是有功效的，比一切两刃的剑更快，甚至魂与灵、骨节与骨髓都能刺入、拨开，连心中的思念和主意都能辨明。
Okay, why have you ever wondered why does God give us the Bible that is filled with language and good languages?
然后你有没有想过这样问？为什么神给我们圣经，然后这个圣经是充满了就是好的那些语言呢？
Okay, because God knows this is how He made us. Our mind uses language, and so your quiet time can actually change your life.
因为神知道我们，他也了解我们，他也知道我们的脑是依靠这一个语言来吸收的，所以通过我们的灵修是吗？我们就能够吸收这一些好的那语言。
You know, you struggle with confidence, right? Oh, so insecure. But the more you read the Bible, the more you see that your big boss, God is with you. I am with you always. The more you really understand that, like what we talk about here, God is the big boss. What does the big boss do? Take care of you. Okay? You become a bit more confident.
所以呢，当我们就是说缺乏信心的时候，对自己缺乏自信心的时候，是吗？如果我们读更多的灵修，更多的那一个圣经的那研讨话，是吗？你可能会觉得就是神就是一直会与我同在的，就好像我们从刚才的那个相对的那些关系的那理论上，我们能够建立这一个间接的关系，然后这个关系让我们会能够体会到、了解到神是与我同在的，所以当你面对问题的时候，面对你老板的时候，什么都会有信心。
Okay, so brothers and sisters, don't skip your quiet time, you know, don't look at the Bible. Your Facebook is not going to change you.
所以呢，弟兄姐妹们，不要看低你的那灵修，然后不要花太多时间，生活在脸书上面，脸书是没办法改变你的。
Your Facebook is not going to make you less anxious. In fact, it'll make you more anxious.
然后脸书是吗？不会让你减轻你的那一个担忧啊，它甚至有可能让你更担忧。
Okay, your Facebook is not going to make you more love. You know? When you see your other friend, hey, wow, he has 1,000 friends, I only 10.
然后脸书是吗？不会让你感受到更多的爱。然后当你跟你的朋友比较的话，是吗？你的朋友可能有1000个。朋友，然后你只是有那10个而已。
So you blah blah blah, you add many friends. Okay, but my point is this: only the Bible. The Bible, see, it says what? You know, it will what? Cut your, it will change. You know, your thoughts, your intention, and your hearts. So, brothers and sisters, okay, the year of the Lord. Let's make sure you dig deep into the Word of God.
所以呢，就好像圣经这边讲的，就是圣经能够把你的思念和主意都分辨清楚，这样。所以今年是神的恩年，让我们深入研讨圣经。
Okay, I'm going to send these few slides to you, all right? In PDF form, read it. Again, go through all these verses in Chinese, because language is important. You read the English, I cannot understand. See, Chinese also very important.Read it, understand it. Then in your D group, discuss about this idea.
所以我会把这个经文送来寄给你们。所以回到家里用你习惯的那个语言是吗去研讨这些经文，这样，然后下个星期在你们 D group 里面然后探讨。
Okay, so in practical terms, watch how you speak to one another. All right, parents, watch how you scold your children, okay? You can still discipline your children, but watch the words and watch your tone.
所以呢，要注意，要小心，看着就是说你和人家交谈的那个语气，然后父母们要注意你们教训孩子的那个语气，这样不是说你不能够教训他们，只不过你教训他们的时候是吗？那一个语气，那一个口口调的话是吗？是怎么样的
？Okay, and this is very important for you. You have to watch how you talk to yourself. You know? When you are not, do you realize if you close your eyes, you can actually hear yourself talking. Do you know that you talk to yourself? It doesn't mean you're crazy. Our mind non-stop talking.
然后接下来是很重要的，就是说你要注意看，就是说你自己跟你自己的交谈。你的思想怎么样？告诉你一些讯息，这样当你闭上眼睛的时候，是吧？你会发现到你的脑是在那边不断的跟自己讲话，这样你不是发神经的。
So you have to watch what you say to yourself. You keep saying, "Why am I so stupid?" Quietly, in your mind, "Why am I so stupid? How come nobody loves me? Why am I like that?" You keep scolding yourself, you know.
所以你要注意，就是说，告诉这些这些思想脑海里面是要告诉自己的那个心声，这样如果你不断聆听到就是说为什么这么笨，为什么这么笨，或者是为什么没有人爱我，为什么爱我话说其实你间接的是在这边伤害着你自己。
Okay, so you gotta learn to let go. Okay, otherwise Zinky Fong will come and find you. Alright, thank you.
所以呢，我们要学习把这一些东西抛开，把这些东西放下，要不然 Zinky Fong 会来找你了。